now you're finished making donuts, you need to filter your shortening every day.
If you have an easy melt, this is a very simple job. All you have to do is open up the drain valve under the fryer and run the shortening through the synthetic filter.
Try to wait till it's cool to about 250 degrees Fahrenheit or 120 degrees Celsius. Hotter than that wears out your filter faster than it should. When the fryer has drained, check how much debris is left behind in your kettle. This debris will make your shortening darker and is not good for frying. So use the rinse hose that comes with the Easy Melt to wash out these bits. Make sure it's turned on, the shortening is liquid, and the hose is properly positioned. Then push the foot pedal to add shortening. With an Easy Melt, you don't ever need to add shortening manually. Every day or two, shake out the contents of the filter. What if you have a filter flow siphon? This is how you put it together. We'll do the bottom first. Then we'll attach the filter bag onto the bottom of the filter flow itself. Right. Now I'll attach the filter flow siphon to the fryer. For this, your fryer has to be close to the edge of the supporting table. Your shortening should be warm enough to be liquid, but not hot enough to burn. That means less than 150 degrees Fahrenheit or 65 degrees Celsius. Now squeeze the bulb until the shortening starts to flow. To stop the flow, loosen the wing nut and lift the end of the filter flow siphon out of the shortening. Use a safe method to pour the shortening back into the fryer. After some time, you can remove the fryer kettle and the conveyor and clean those thoroughly. You can also carry out an approved boil out procedure to remove stains. If you do, remember never to let any water at all mix with your shortening. The water will boil inside the shortening and that is not safe at all. So be smart, be safe, keep your donut robot as clean as possible, and keep on making those delicious donuts.